Next, we solve here the question number 3 of exercise 7.2. Now, you have to show that triangle AMP is congruent to triangle AMQ. The figure has been given here, triangle AMP, triangle AMQ. In the following proof, supply the missing reasons that can be. So, if we say PM is equal to QM, how can we say that? First condition, the reason can be that it is PM is equal to QM is given to us in the question itself. So the reason can be given. Second part, angle PMA is equal to angle QMA. PMA, that means this angle, angle PMA is equal to angle QMA. So how can we say that? Because it is also given to us in the question, so the reason is given. Third part, AM equal to AM. So if we look at the figure, this side AM is common to both the triangles. So what will it be? Common side. The reason here will be common side. And the fourth part says, triangle AMP is congruent to triangle AMQ. So now with the three given pair of equal parts, what can we judge? That we were talking about the two corresponding sides of these two triangles and the included angle. So which criteria did we use here? By SAS congruence rule, we can say that the triangles are congruent. We can again look at the figure and notice the answers that we have given. PM equal to QM because it was given in the question. Angle PMA equal to angle QMA. Again, it was given in the question. AM equal to AM. From the figure, we could easily judge that it was the common side and the triangles were congruent by SAS congruence rule. Next, we come to question number 4. Exercise 7.2. So again, this exercise 7.2, question number 4. The question says, in triangle ABC, angle A equal to 30 degree, angle B equal to 40 degree, and angle C equal to 110 degree. In triangle PQR, angle P equal to 30 degree, angle Q equal to 40 degree, and angle R equal to 110 degree. Now a student says that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by AAA congruence criterion. Is he justified? Why or why not? So when we talked about the congruence criteria, we never talked about the condition related to three angles, that if we are able to find three angles of one triangle equal to the three angles of another triangle. So if I draw a figure like this, that these two angles are equal, then the second pair of angles is equal, and the third pair of angles is also equal. But we never talked about it, that this also can be a condition to say that the triangles are congruent. Why? Because there is no such condition. There is no criteria like AAA congruence criteria. There is no AAA congruence criteria. So we cannot say. So that means when the student said this, it was not justified. There is no AAA congruence rule. Okay. And how can we support our answer that there is no congruence rule? Let us just try with the given measurements itself. We were given here that triangle ABC, angle A equal to 30 degree, angle B equal to 40 degree, and angle C equal to 110 degree. So we'll do it with the same here. We'll construct triangle ABC here with the given measurements. Angle A equal to 30 degree, angle B equal to 40 degree, and angle C equal to 110 degree. Now let us construct a triangle with the given measurements. See, we have not been given anything about any of the sides, so we can choose the side on our own. So I am choosing side AB. as 5 cm in the first case. That's 5 cm AB. Now the angles are already given to me, so I have to construct it accordingly. I'll say angle A equal to 30 degree, so I'll mark 30 degree here. So what is this angle? This is 30 degree. Now I'll construct angle B equal to 40 degree. So angle B is equal to 40 degree. And this was 5 cm. And naturally, when angle A and angle B were these, so angle C was 110 degree here. Next, we come to some other calculation, some other construction now. In the second case, we'll choose the sides to be a little different. Now, this time we are going to construct triangle PQR. Again, the angles are all same. Angle P is equal to 30 degree. Angle Q is equal to 40 degree and angle R is equal to 110 degree. Again, nothing has been given to us related to the sides of the triangle. So, we will construct the triangle taking a side of our own choice. So, this time I am taking the side to be 7 cm. I'll just make it once again. So this is 7 cm. This is side PQ. PQ. Now at point, vertex P, what is the angle P given to us here? Angle P is 30 degrees. So we'll construct it like that. Angle P equal to 30 degrees. And angle Q is equal to 40 degrees. So this is 30 degree, this is 40 degree, and by the angle sum property, the third angle has to be 110 degree. Okay. Now, if you see these two triangles, can you say that they are congruent? We can easily see that triangle ABC is smaller than triangle PQR. So that means if the three angles are equal, even if in the two triangles, the three angles are equal, one triangle can be an enlarged copy of the other one. So we cannot say that the triangles are congruent by AAA congruence rule. So this activity was a justification for our answer when we said that the AAA congruence rule cannot be applied.